In the previous video, we've imported data. So we've gone from a data source to the raw data. However, we need some data wrangling still. And maybe you've noticed in the exercises that our data isn't exactly perfect. Like crude oil, it needs some refinement in order to be processable for further data analysis. So one of the things you might have noticed is here, if we go to line 1578, let's go there with GoTo that you can bring up with F5, you see that the headers are repeated. Because we've merged the six CSV files into one, also the headers are replicated. Do you know how to fix this? Maybe you've seen this in a previous MOOC or somewhere else. There are a few techniques you can use to get rid of this duplication. There'll be a little quiz afterwards where you can show us whether you know how to fix this. Okay, welcome back. But there are some worse scenarios in our data. For example, if we look at loyalty, some of them have a loyalty number and others have three dashes. So if we add some analysis on top of that, naively, let's calculate how many purchasers are there without a loyalty card. If we would do that, just by looking at the first few rows, we would do a count if on column K on all of the loyalties, and we would count everywhere where it is three dashes. But unfortunately, this is not the correct value, because if we look at loyalty, and an easy way to find this is adding a filter. If we scroll back, if we look at loyalty here, we see that some of the values are zero. So this is probably not loyalty card number zero that's making all these purchases. In some of the branches, they are saving loyalty as zero instead of three dashes. So what we can do is we can do some calculation to make the data look more consistent. What we can do is we go to loyalty. There we go, loyalty. And we make a loyalty processed column where we're going to say, okay, in one of these three scenarios, either it is blank, or it is zero, or it's three dashes. In one of those three scenarios, we're going to give back one value. It doesn't really matter which one we pick. Let's here pick three dashes. There we go, three dashes in that scenario. And otherwise, we're going to give the loyalty value. So if we use that formula, we can drag it down. There we go. And now you see that everywhere, even if the loyalty is zero, we get three dashes. And also if the loyalty is blank, in any case, we get three dashes. Nice and consistent. Whatever is in column K, column L will look nice. So one thing to notice here is that I'm now doing this in the input sheet. I'm putting it right next to the input data. I'm just doing that because this is a video and it's a lot of work to switch the worksheets all the time. Normally, and this is what you're going to do in the exercises as well, you would put that in a separate worksheet because you want to separate input data and formula. So this is just an example. This is not how you normally would do it. What you might have also noticed is that there are even worse things wrong with our data. If we go here to the sales price, we select that. Again, we can easily use a filter to see all the values that are there. Some of the values have a dollar sign, where others do not have a dollar sign. And you might think, is this a problem or not? We can ask Excel. So we can ask, are these two values the same? And Excel says true, yes, both of them are the same. So it's just a layout issue. It's not really a problem. One thing, though, is really a problem. Some of these values have commas in them. Let's select one. And we want to know, is this a problem? So one of the things you can always try to see if values are normal is to do some calculation with them. If we add these two values, it's not working. Why could that be? Well, one of the guesses we can take is that maybe this is a text value. And we can ask Excel, hey, is this a text? Do you also think that this is text? Yes, says Excel, it's true, this is text. And that means that at least we know what is wrong. And I'll show you one formula that you can use to convert text to numbers if Excel hasn't done it automatically, because sometimes it just goes naturally. Let me show you how that works. So we're going to get rid of the isText. We don't need that anymore. Let's delete that. What we're going to do is the number value function, where you can put in a text. We know now that this is text, so we can put it in. And then we can say, what is the decimal separator in this number? So in this case, of course, you've seen that. It is a comma. And if we close that formula off, we get a nice value, 100, a real value. And we can drag that down. Here I'm just doing it over the filter, but of course you could do it over all of the rows. And just to verify that we've done it correctly, we can add a formula on top of it, and then we see, yes, yes, it's real data, because if we add 100 to 100, we get 200 instead of value like we got before. So your exercise to close off this week is to clean all of this data in order to prepare for the data analysis that we will be doing next week. Good luck!